Yo, what's going on? It's Momo, Head Movement TV, Hala Mala Talavala.
Welcome to Sheffield, my brother.
How you doing, bro?
I'm all right, thank you. I'm good.
Yeah, we're here at the Kell Brook and Zarafa public workout. Before we get to this fight, I just want to speak to you about the Fury Wilder.
Yeah.
What did you make of the decision?
I think it stunk. I think everybody thinks it stunk. I think, and I'm passionate about the decision making of judges, and I think it's happened before. It happened again, and it'll happen again.
Until we
do something about it. So at the moment, the same thing's going to happen again. It's hot talk of the town at the moment, and then in a week's time, people forget about it. Oh yeah, that happened. The judge, whatever. The Mexican judge could actually be here. You don't know what he looks like. You know his name. What I say they do is, when something like that happens, you make that judge sit down with a camera on him, like you've got one on me, put the fight on, and tell him to justify each round. And tell us how he scored each round, because the Mexican judge had the first six rounds to Deontay Wilder. Tell him to do that on camera so the public can see who he is. So you put a face to this foolishness, then people are going to be less inclined to think, okay, people forget about it, it's all right. That's not how you're going to do it. You've got to name and shame these people. Mm-hmm. Because at the moment, you can do it, it'll be big news for a week. It's all done. You go quiet, go to ground, get a little refereeing job in some little hick town or something like that and sneak your way back into it again. To me, it stinks. It stinks. It stinks because when I was watching it, I was around fight fans, casuals, and a guy said to me, I love, he goes, great fight. I'll never watch boxing again. I said, why? He said, it's corrupt. Mm-hmm. I had no argument. Yeah. What could I say? This is what he said. I thought, well, I said, no, it's not. He said, well, we know won. Why didn't he win? I thought, I had no argument. It kills our sport. So when the guys are in the ring, they're the ones that's risking their life. They're mm-hmm. the ones that it's their livelihood. And it's controlled by some incompetent outside the ring. That's where we have an issue.
Yeah, it's terrible. Yeah, like when everyone's trying to talk about the two knockdowns, but there's no justification for the first five, six rounds going to Deontay Wilder.
That's right. So that's what I'm saying. So even the two knockdowns or whatever, he's still Deontay didn't win that fight, and he knows he didn't win that fight. You know, Deontay put a post up the other today actually. And it showed the count. Mm-hmm. All right, I see that. Have that as your argument. Have that as your argument. But don't have the argument to say, yeah, it was a draw, man. Have that as the argument.
Supposedly, the count that he's posted up is a sped-up version. And if you watch Frank Warren's posted one back where you can do it yourself, basically.
I hope that's not the line Deontay's gone down, because I don't think he's that kind of guy. Mm-hmm. And if he has...
No, I don't think he would have sped it up himself. Yeah. But I think he's found it on social media.
Had
a look and thought, hang on.
Yeah, so to me, I think Deontay, if he's the man, he gives us the impression he is. Mm-hmm. I think he'll want a rematch. Yeah. Because if he doesn't take a rematch, then he's kind of becoming the person he says Anthony Joshua is.
Yeah.
If I was Deontay, I'd want to say, nah, man, I've got to right this wrong.
Yeah.
That's what you do. There's no reason why it can't be done again. You've got it. There's a possibility to be good. You don't have to fight him again.
Yeah.
But to me, I'd want to right the wrong instantly.
What did you make of the performance? Fury's performance in particular?
I think Fury's performance was about boxing, the sweet science, hit and not be hit. Wilder got beat on basic boxing. Jab, jab, triple jab, left, right, movement, back and forth. And Dyson did it with ease. It was funny because he weighed box like a black American, smooth, bap, 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 dropping it on him. And Wilder was like an Eastern European just trying to whack him out. I'm thinking, relax yourself up, man. Use the jab. Get some straight shots to him, set him up. So it shows that Deontay's success has come from brawn more than brain, which has worked for him so far.
But it showed
that if you're tall, if you've got longer reach than him, and he's not got a physical advantage over you, as in height and reach, then if you box him, you'll beat him.
Yeah.
But you've got to give Deontay credit, because Deontay came in at 15 stone one.
Yeah.
Look how he knocked down a big man like Tyson Fury.
I don't think I can ever remember the smaller man being the aggressor. It's very rare anyway.
Oh, Mike Tyson.
Mike Tyson is the obvious one. But
and that's
he's
what I'm
quite
saying.
Thick, even though he's short.
What happens, you know, as a cruiserweight, you can fight a lot of heavyweights because you've got speed on him. You've got the power of a heavyweight, but the movement of a light heavyweight. Deontay Wilder is close to cruiserweight, so he has that speed, but he also has that power, and he showed it. And I was impressed how he took Tyson out in the last round.
He essentially took him out.
Took him out. and showed that power, punch power. So you've got to give it to him.
Has it changed your opinion on both of them facing Joshua? It's slightly changed mine on both.
Well, I thought Saturday night would give us a definitive direction of what's happening. But realistically, no. We're still in the same position. As far as I'm concerned, those two need to fight each other again.
Styles make away. Fights then.
And then let's then talk. And they've it's how do you justify one fighting over the other?
Mm-hmm.
You know, Tyson Fury unofficially won. Mm-hmm. Deontay Wilder's the official champion. Make him sort it out. Sort it out again.
Mm.
Winner takes all. Steps in.
And
Anthony Joshua's been cool about it. Set back. Go on, boys. I'll give the toss.
Yeah,
I'm still king. I'm the one with all the bells.
It's true. Okay, moving on to Kell Brook and Zarafa. Kell Brook looking very sharp.
Yeah, he does. I saw him in the ring and I thought, wow.
A bit
of
stinging,
you know, for the first time, he's got a spring in his step. He looked like he's enjoying training. He's enjoying being fit. My trainer, Brendan Ingle, said, you've got to make it your lifestyle. And I think that's what Kell's done out there in Fuerte Ventura. And that's what he needed.
Yeah.
There's no love lost between him and Dominic. You know, what he wanted, what Dominic wanted, two different things. Kell wanted to spend 3 months away training. Dominic said, I've got a gym to run, I've got a fight to take care of, but I can't do that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how it is. It's cool.
Mm-hmm.
But it showed its work for Kell. He knows what he needed.
Reports come out this week that Terence Crawford has offered Amir Khan $5 million.
Yeah.
To fight over there, and that would obviously put the Brook fight on hold again. Do you think that would affect Brook in any way? Or
listen, obviously Brook wants that fight because it's a big payday, but realistically he needs to forget that fight.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't gonna happen. You can only say no in so many ways without actually saying no, I don't want to fight you.
Mm-hmm.
And Amir Khan has done that, and so Cal needs to forget it, let it go. It ain't gonna happen. And Amir Khan probably just believes that he'll not beat Kell. That's all it alludes to. Even mm-hmm. his fans are now doubting him, saying, come on, man, why are you not taking this fight? This, you'll beat him, whatever. You know, and whatever the reason is, Amir doesn't believe he'll pull it off.
Mm-hmm.
And so you just got to let it go. Let it go, he just won't. He just won't. It's a shame, but Amir don't care about public pressure.
Yeah.
He's shown it.
Yeah.
I don't think he ever has.
If you look at his social media comments and stuff, he's never cared.
So no matter what he said or done, he ain't budging. I can remember seeing Virgil Hunter in Los Angeles, and Virgil was a Khan's trainer, and he said to me, he will never fight Brook. And Virgil Hunter's a good trainer.
Mm-hmm.
He said in one arm, he will never fight Brook.
He picked that up off him.
Yeah.
Do you fancy Khan's chances against Crawford if it was to happen?
Yeah, Khan is one of the fastest fighters I've seen. I think I fancy Khan's chances against Brook. You understand? Khan is a class fighter, but he's a vulnerable class fighter. So it's a case of, you know, he's getting there with Crawford, and trust me, don't be surprised if they fight each other and Khan's ahead on points.
Yeah.
But it's a case of if he gets clapped.
Yeah.
That's a problem.
See, Crawford generally outboxes you till it hurts. It's not so much of a big shot to end it, and he's usually always ahead on points.
Yeah, but Khan's the kind of guy where you don't have to really hit him hard to get rid of him.
Because Vargas is the one, two, the fake left and the right hand wasn't the biggest shot.
Yeah, that's right. So you don't have to hit Khan hard to hurt him. You're just going to hit
him. Yeah. Okay, that's no problem. Johnny Nelson on Momo Head Movement TV. Hala Mala Talavala. Thank you for your time. Bit of head movement. I seen you doing the splits the other day.
That's how
can you still do them?
No
chance. All right, thank you very much.